Hi all. Now let's go with our agenda for today. First, we'll talk about Docker, Docker Compose, Docker Swarm, and show some commands also that you can run. What is Docker? Okay, why exactly Docker come into existence, guys? There are two reasons that Docker come into existence. One reason is, suppose I want to run one Java application, right? Now to run that Java application, what I need to do is I need to set up proper environment of Java. That's absolutely correct. Similarly, what happened is now I need to pass this application to someone. What they need to do? They also need to particularly make the same environment for them. Now it becomes sometimes tedious. Why tedious? Because ultimately, if 10 developers are there, everyone need to set up that deployment cycle. Or in other words, we can say that suppose my manager come to me and say I want to run the application on my system. Now I know that to set up that application on his or her system, it take around say 1 day. But manager want to see that application running on the system, now it become difficult. So what should we do that it become easy to run the deployment on the anyone system very fast? So guys, the very first advantage is what we do is we make the Docker container of the application. What is Docker container? In short, we can say it's like a one container. Okay, all the thing I set up here means starting from Java, JDK, GRE, whatever I want. Basically, I need to set up in the container. Okay, and whenever the anybody want to run the application, I'll not ask them to set up the application on the system. Then what I'll ask? I'll ask them to just run this container and their application start running. In short, we can say that instead of anybody setting the application, now they no need to set up everything on the system. What they can do is they can directly go and run the application on their system using the Docker container. That's the first advantage. Second advantage, like now they won't deploy the application. Now they don't need to set up anything for the on the server. They just run the container over the server. In short, it make a one-time process. That one you make that container. Now this container can be run over any system without setting up any kind of environment on the system. In short, we can say that the best benefit of using the container is that set up the container and run the application over the container. If anybody need it, just give them the container and use it. Clear? Container is a place over which the application run. Now if anybody want to use the application, they will just run that application inside the container, and that container I can pass to anyone. Okay, so Dockerization is a package your application and all it dependency together in a form of container to ensure that your application works seamlessly in any environment by development, test or prod. In short, we can say that if anybody create a container, now they can directly run the container onto their system instead of running one setting anything one by one. That's the benefit, guys. Okay, one more thing I'll show you. Suppose somebody made one hotel, okay? That's a very big hotel, but the only point of that hotel is it have only one room in the hotel. Okay, they have only very big room, but that's a single big room in the hotel. Now when they give this hotel for a rent, now what happened? Very few people are interested for that case. Why so? Reason why very few people are interested for this hotel is because this hotel have only one room. Now being a one room, very less people are interested. Only reason, because everybody need their own space, everybody need a privacy, which they will not get when they have just a very big one single room. Now to overcome this problem, what the hotel owner did, that now instead of having a one single room, they divided that room into the many small rooms. Okay, now instead of having a one single room, they have divided that hotel into small rooms. Now after that, once they made that small rooms, like suppose one room, two room, like that. When they make the small rooms, now what happened? A lot of people are interested. Why? Because everybody will get their own space, which was not happening earlier. Now it's happening because of their own space. Similarly, guys, what happened in the applications? In the applications, suppose I want to run a Java application. I got one server to run the Java application. So after that, what happened is once I get the Java application running over the server, tomorrow somebody come to me and say, I want to run the Python application also. Now I need to run Python over the server. Correct. So that become one more task. Ultimately, somebody come and say, no, run the .NET also over that. So it become one more task. In short, what happened is if I have to run the multiple different kind of application on one single server, it become difficult at later stages. The reason for that is because every application need its own environment, and when we have this different environment, it for on single server, it become difficult to handle. To overcome this problem, we have only one single server. Over single server, I'll run one container for Python, one container for Java, one container for Node, one container for Ruby, like that way. And with this, the best part that happen is now when we getting a one, each of them are getting a separate space. So one server now can handle the multiple different application. It's a cost reduction as well as having a one application over single server. So that is why, guys, Docker is most preferred in this current market. And every application these days are using a Docker. I hope, guys, by this, you guys are clear what is Docker. So container will have OS as well. Now container is by default having an OS called Linux OS, but you don't have access to install any OS over the container. Container run over the host OS means like over my window machine, I can run the Docker container. It's like that. But container don't have any OS setup. Perfect. Now, RAM consumed by the container is less than consumed by the VM. First thing, easily run application by packaging them into container. Containers are lightweight, can be easily shared via Docker Hub. I'm not sure you heard about this thing or not. There's one thing called GitHub, guys, where we share our codes in very similar way. We have one thing called Docker Hub. Now Docker Hub is similar to GitHub, as GitHub is help to share the code, right? Whereas Docker Hub help to share the Docker images. So Docker Hub help us to share the images. Some images are pre-built, some images we use. You will see multiple images here. See, these are the images which I have created. Okay. And if we go to explore, for everything, there one thing called Apache. See, guys, we find a one image for Apache, Tomcat, Maven. For every single thing, the image is there. Whatever we want to use, we can call it and use it. Okay. So what is Docker container? First of all, understand what is Docker. Now, container is an isolated application platform which contain everything needed to run the application. In short, it's a platform over which I can run any application. Now, they are built from one base Docker image and dependencies are installed on the top of the image layer. So in a sync, we make a layer. Suppose you want to run the Node application, right? So first of all, you will install the node over your platform. Means in a container, we install the Node.js. Once the Node.js got installed in my container, then the next thing which I will do is install the dependency. Suppose I am making a React application. So then I'll set up all the dependency of React over that container. How we do that? Let me show you a simple example of creating a container. First of all, guys, you must have the Docker in your system. Simply say, download Docker. When you do like that, you will get Docker direct option to download. Okay. Now, once you get the option, just download that. So after that, you will see this icon, guys. This ship, and over the ship, you have this containers. Because one Docker contain the multiple containers, so it's like a container service only. So it's a ship. Over that ship, you see this containers, right? If you see this icon, if you click on that in Windows, you see it below. In the Mac, you'll see it here. In the Linux also, you see on the top, you will see Docker is running. And if Docker is running, then anyways it's good. So only point is this, you have to make sure this Docker is running. Now suppose I have any application. As example, I'll give you, I'll pick any random application of Node.js. It's not about a Node.js, it's about any application. Let me just give an example for that case. So I go to classes. Now I'll go to an application, say weather app. Okay, whatever application you want to container. Suppose I have this application, I want to run this application over a Docker container. What I'll do, I'll make one file by the name of Docker file. D should be capital and then rest. It should be named as Docker file, like this, exactly like this. Now you have to tell the step that what step we follow. Now for doing that particularly, very first thing is we install the Node.js. Okay. Now, once that Node.js got installed in my system, then the next thing I'll do is I'll make a one directory inside the container. Okay. Then once that directory got created, then the next thing I'll do is I'll copy the package, or this means I start copying a package from my application to the container. Then after that, next thing I'll do is I'll write run npm install, then I will install all the things over this container. Okay, all dependencies. Then after that, I'll copy rest of my code. Then I'll expose the port number over which this application should run, and then we write the command to run this inside the container. So I'm trying to run an application inside the container. Now, how we can do that? So once you write this command, now guys, you have to run two commands. So we are in my folder, right? Actually, look commands. The first command you will run is Docker build, okay, minus dot minus the name of the image. To see the Docker running or not, just type Docker here. You will see a lot of commands. Let me show you. You'll see a lot of commands like this. Okay. Then after that, to see what all images are there, we'll write Docker image ls. This will show you what all images are there. When I run this command particularly, guys, it will basically create one image like this. You see one image? This kind of image is going to be created. Then after that, I run this command to run the application. See, I take this command and run. Let's see. So we'll find it. So we'll do one thing. We'll first create the image once again. We'll go to desktop, classes, main node. Now cd weather app. So run this command from where you have the Docker file. So this is creating a one Docker image of this application. Is let get created, then we'll run this. Now let get generated. See guys, it's creating a one Docker image for us. Okay. Now it's generated. Next, let's run this application. So this time we are running the application. So if we see the application internally, it's running a port number 7899, but we have exposed the port 8989. If we try, we'll go to localhost 8989, 8989. you will see one application running over this container. Let's get started. Wait for a minute. Okay. See guys, your application running now. Even I don't have any Node.js installed in my system also. No, I don't need to worry about because I have the image and this image is running my application. See, so I'll show one image. The image is created. So if I write here, no, Docker image ls. See guys, about a minute ago, this image got created. See, to see what the container is running, right? Docker ps, right? No container running. Let's start the application once. In one new tab, Docker ps. See guys, you see one container is created. Container ID, image name, command, time, status, and the path rights. In short, we can say that these images are created and can be used. Sir, anything can be done. Your var or any file, you have to read the document of that more, and you can apply any kind of file over that. So we have already seen how to create container, right? So Docker container is an isolated application platform which contain everything needed to run the application. So as already mentioned that you can use it to run any means, any kind of application, guys. Okay, fine. They are built from one base Docker image, and it's also possible. Suppose guys, I want to do something more extra on my application. No, so on one Docker container, we can run multiple things. Like I can run the database also. I can run the application also in single container itself. But for doing that, we have to get another file called docker compose.yml. So we have Docker file, Docker image, upload to Docker Hub and start serving that, guys. How do we get a Docker container? So Docker files are used to build a Docker images, and that images will contain the project code. The same image can be used to spin n number of container. So guys, the one we create Docker image, right? With that, I can run the n number of container. Whoever need it, they just pull it and run it. So we're running multiple application, no? It's a multiple thing on one container. We make one file called Docker compose. Docker compose.yml. Like this, and in this we can add a configuration to run multiple application over one Docker container. Okay, now what is Docker compose? As I already explained you, Docker compose is used to run multi applications. Those who want to know what is supported, simply go to Docker Hub, click on explore, okay, and search what you're looking for. If that image is available, it will support. Suppose that PHP. See, but time is gone. Nobody uses PHP these days. But if you're using it, upgrade yourself. It's very old now. So each container will run as a standalone application. It can communicate with each other, present on a same host. Suppose if you have multiple containers are there, right? To manage multiple container, we can use a guys Docker compose also, or in one container we can run multiple things. So in one case, if you're using a Docker compose, right, then in that case what you need to do is you can under, suppose I have one MERN, means Mongo Express Angular Node. All these things can be run using different container but same command. It is possible I have a compose file, Docker file 1, Docker file 2, and it run multiple containers and running the same application over that. Now why we need a Docker swarm? The point like that, guys, why exactly a Docker swarm is, if we have more than one container, right, it's more like clusters, guys. What happen now when you run one single image of Docker? Sometimes the complete application does not work over that. Okay, so what we do in that case, what we do is use a Docker swarm. So ultimately, Docker Swarm is one thing. If we have more than one container, okay, if I want to run that for that particular case, guys, we use a Docker Swarm to scale the application. Suppose my application is running. Now that application stop, okay, the container break or container don't have a space. How to manage them? So ultimately, to manage them particularly, guys, we use Docker Swarm. Okay, to manage multiple containers, we have to use Docker Swarm. So services deployed in any node can be accessed from other node in the same cluster. So for that case, what we do is we make one cluster. Now, what is that cluster is? Cluster is like you make a one group. In that one single group, you can have the multiple application guys, or in one single group, you can have the multiple containers also. That is basically referred as your Docker cluster. So cluster is a collection of multiple container altogether, and that make our one single application. So for high availability of services, auto load balancing. Load balancing means basically what happen guys, when we run the application over one single server, no, sometimes not capable of handling all the load. To manage that load, we have to scale the application called horizontal scaling. Now to scale that application, we need a mechanism. So Docker Swarm have a inbuilt mechanism. Now if somebody asks me Docker Swarm is equivalent to Kubernetes guys. Kubernetes is provided by the Google, whereas Swarm is provided by their own company, Docker. Point is like that right now. Kubernetes use much many believe the Kubernetes reason because it's more popular in market. Whereas if you talk about the functionality reach and ease of learning, Docker Swarm is the best option. But right now, market is switching to the Docker Swarm, but not all. So Docker Swarm and Kubernetes same thing. The Docker Swarm is built by their own Docker as a company. But whereas it's possible that guys it automatically scale. Suppose it's required 10 Docker container. No, it can run the 10 Docker container over one application. Decentralized access. It's not like that only one machine can handle all the thing. We can have multiple container to handle the multiple different things. In this cluster, now guys, we have two things. One is a manager and one is a node. The one single manager from where we manage all the things. So manager is a one container that you have created through which you manage the node. Now it's a two thing can happen. While running the application, I can that because you run the application over the manager directly. We can run my whole application on just a manager node. That's possible. But if I want, I can run the application over manager as well, and as well as the other node also. So if you run in the mode called global mode, then what happen? I'll show you how to do that. If you're doing that way, then you will see that in the all the modes. Okay. Then you will see that in the manager also, node one also, node two also. But in case you don't specify the mode as global, then only run inside the manager node. There's some commands, guys. First is to initialize a swarm. To initialize a swarm, you need your own IP address. Ideally, for doing this demo and all, there are multiple servers that we cannot perform here. I'll show you by picturizing it how we do it. First, I want an IP of my system. I say IP config. If config here. So where is our IP? 192.168.0.104, right? Now command will be, I'll make a new tab. The command for running a swarm is, you'll write Docker swarm. Then you have to give init. Init means initialize the cluster. So basically, to initialize that cluster, we use a init command. Now, with the help of init, that swarm got initialized and make a one cluster for us. Let's see that init. Now, what you need to do is you need to write advertise the node. Okay. So we write next thing is advertise node and give the IP of your system base. So we write here advertise address and the IP. Our IP is something 192. Let's just pick it once again. That is 192.168.0.104. If I run this form, so if I run this command here, so did we misspell something? Yeah, SWARM, wrong spelling. Yes, once it do that swarm, no, you will get this code. Okay, now what you need to do with this code, once you get this code, this should happen that you have only one server where all things are running. Now for doing this means it should be on the same network. Ideally we cannot do that right now here. In a real time we'll show you by doing on a cluster. Now once you get this, if you check what all nodes you have right now, Docker node ls. Okay, the benefit of doing that is for high availability. Right now only one node called leader node. Now ultimately what you need to do is this command that you got, you need to run this command in that different servers. So what all servers are there, you have to copy paste this particular command. So docker swarm join. In my system, no, it will not work directly, but I'm just showing you. If I run this command like this, it not work because it's a single node. So I'll show the commands. First of all, you run this in the manager node. We run this docker, initialize the docker guys swarm in the manager node. Now in the worker node, or say node one, so in return, I'll share this notes with you. In return, you will get key. This looks something like this. This kind of key got generated guys. Now in the node one, basically we run this key. Similarly in node two, we run this key. After doing that, so in master, if we run docker node ls, so you will see, so right now if I run this, you only see one, correct, but the output will be, you will see many. So how you'll see many, I'll just want you see id host ready like that. In below this you will see some id, then you will see this node one and some IP here and some server engine like this, and similarly you will see node two also like this. Basically once you run this initialize a swarm, then copy this code into each of your node, it will put them into one single cluster. It look very similar to this diagram like this guys. We'll have one manager node and multiple child nodes. Now guys, next thing, once my cluster got generated, okay, now what we'll do is we will run the application over that container. Now how to start any application, so like this, in the master node, no guys, you will run this command. I'll do one thing, all this I'll create one file system docker swarm. Now this time in manager node, what you have to do is you'll write docker run minus, the command will bit change, I'll show you. You write docker service create minus minus name of the application main node, now I'll write as main node, then hyphen p port, and by which name you want to run, I'll say my app one any name. Now what this will do, this will run that. First of all, by default what it do, it will run this on the manager node. If I go back now, it will pull that image and run that. But right now it's only going to see, it's preparing that. Once it done, it's going to run. But the only point right now is it's going to run guys over your master node. And then the docker service ls, you can see the service is running. once it is created, if I check in a master node, like docker service ls, in this case you will see a service running on the manager node. It will be running on manager node, but suppose I have multiple three VMs, three virtual machines over which they are running. So if I go to any other VM also, suppose the node one running on the VM one, node two running on VM two. So if I go and try running the application, in those also application must be running. In short, we can say that if we run like this, it will be just running over a one single node. That's your master node. But if you check, you will see that it's running on the master node, but the pod right now, it's only one pod that is inside the master node. But application is running on the all the pods. Means all the VMs can see that where this containers, where these nodes are running, no? On those machines also the application is running. But the pod right now it consume is a master pod or say manager. Now you want it to run on multiple pods also, that you want to scale it. Now for running on multiple pod, your command will be changed, guys. By this point, we will able to run application on all servers, but pod is just running in master. Okay. Now you want that the pod should also be available in all other nodes. So first of all, delete this service. Docker service rm and service name. My service name is my node. So ultimately, guys, we'll stop this. Now we can again start the application on the multiple pods. For doing that, you need to change a bit command. Now the command that you will see here is after your port number, write hyphen hyphen mode as global. Now what I do? Now if you go to each pod, you will see that application is running on each and every pod as well. Clear? So this is how we do and this is how it work. Perfect, guys, thanks a lot for joining. Thank you and bye bye. Take care, stay safe, stay at home.